And joining us now in our studio is Dr. Dean Blumberg. He's with UC Davis Health. His specialty is pediatric infectious diseases, and he's here right now to talk about this new coronavirus. So let's start with that case out of Solano County. We know this is a person who didn't travel to one of these countries that's had an outbreak, didn't have contact, at least known, with someone who's been diagnosed. So how significant is this?
So what public health is telling us is that opposed to the previous cases that either traveled to an infected area like China, or they had contact with somebody who traveled there, this case, they don't know where this person got it from. So they presumably got it from casual contact with somebody in the community, which indicates that this virus is out there. It's being circulated in the community.
So let's talk, like, just in real terms, what community exposure means. Is it just like I shake hands with you, walk by you in a grocery store? What kind of contact would you have to have?
So it's primarily transmitted by droplet transmission, and that means coughing or sneezing. And then the virus can be suspended in the air for up to 6 feet away from the person who coughs or sneezes. So that's the primary way that it's going to be transmitted. It can also be transmitted if somebody coughs or sneezes on a surface like a doorknob or a shopping cart, and then you touch it and then you touch your face.
Okay, so when you feel like yuck, when you can hear somebody cough or sneeze behind you, that's real. That could actually be sending this virus out into the air.
You don't want to be around that person.
Yeah, sometimes you don't know till it's happened.
But exactly.
So then what? Then how can people protect themselves given that this could be on a shopping cart handle or on a doorknob?
So the primary thing is that we want people who are sick to stay out of public. So stay home, don't go to work, don't go to school. Be nice to your fellow coworkers. If you are sick, cough into your sleeve, not into your hand, because then you'll touch things. And then for other people, try not to be around sick people. If somebody is sick, move away from them. And then use good hand hygiene. So make sure to wash your hands, soap and water, or the alcohol-based hand gels before touching your face, before eating.
So, Dr. Blumberg, this is the advice that we usually get from you with just the normal cold and flu season, which we should point out the coronavirus is. This is a new strain. So why is this new strain so much more dangerous? And as an infectious disease doc, how worried are you about this new strain?
So this is a new strain, as you mentioned, and it's evolved so that nobody in the world has been exposed to it before. That means everybody in the world is susceptible to getting infected, and that's the danger. Now, on the other hand, most cases are going to be mild. And so the numbers we have so far is about 80% of the cases are mild, 20% are severe, about 2% of people who have this are dying. So that's of great concern. But you have to realize that what we've been testing is just the tip of the iceberg. So there are probably a lot of many mild cases, asymptomatic cases that are out there. We haven't tested them. I expect the severity numbers, the case fatality rate, those numbers should be falling once we do more widespread testing.
Because you'll have so many more people in that pool.
Exactly, more people who have mild infection, so that'll dilute that, exactly.
So how is it diagnosed?
So it's diagnosed with a PCR test, so that's detecting the genetic material of the virus, and it's done primarily by a swab, so a nasal or oral swab.
And this is so new, there are no treatments, but it sounds like, you know, we've got a lot of people working on that. How close do you think we are?
Well, there are studies that are ongoing, so they've already set those up. There's some antivirals that look good in the lab that they inhibit the virus. We just don't know if they work well in people. So those studies are being done, and in addition, vaccines are being looked at.
Right.
They have yet to begin clinical trials, but those are expected to be starting soon. We have several promising candidates.
Great.
We need to make sure we know the dose and if they're safe and all those other issues.
Which just takes time.
Takes time.
All right, Dr. Blumberg, as always, thank you for your expertise.
Thank you.